Hi everybody, Silas here. In this video I will be showing you how to successfully install LoadGen, specifically the Loads and Performance suite. We will start this installation video with grabbing the trial version, and shortly after that we'll check the environment requirements needed and start with the installation. As you can see, there are multiple products to choose from. Today we will choose for the Load and Performance testing suite. You will receive an email to start downloading the LoadGen Configurator. This is the base for installing LoadGen on a Windows virtual machine. Need to activate the accounts, and afterwards we receive the login credentials needed to activate our trial version. Please save the login credentials as we need this during the installation. The link for the minimum system requirements is in the description of this video. The minimal requirements are quite low. You don't need the most beefiest machines or the latest greatest, but it's supported on almost all operating systems for Windows, and it comes with a few prerequisites like net framework and VC redistributables. We will have our own little environment with us, Windows Server 2019 VM and a Windows 10 VM to use this demo installation. Start by firing up our demo environments. I've created the loadgenguru.com local domain and joined the server where we install LoadGen to this domain and the Windows 10 VM as well. I will be using a domain admin account for this demo, but for production purposes please use a local admin which you can apply via GPO. Installation configurator will automatically open, and we will pick the option which is called activate LoadGen with a LoadGen cloud account. This is the account we received earlier in an email, and please log in with the supplied account details. Start the installation with clicking the button download and install. This will install three different components. One is LoadGen Director, and LoadGen Studio, and LoadGen Analyzer. LoadGen Director is the main system from where you start the test. LoadGen Studio is where you can edit the test, and LoadGen Analyzer is where you check the results from the tests. We also need to install the VC runtime libraries, which are needed for LoadGen. For a production environment, you should look into an SQL server, not the one we're using now. This is purely for demo purposes. This SQL server will be used for storing the results or performance metrics during the tests. For this installation, this demo installation, I will use a simple SQL Express instance. Save the connection string as we need this later. If you need more information about the terminology, please visit the link in the description. For this test, we will set up a FAT client machine. This is in fact a VM, but in this terminology, it's a FAT client. This machine will be called the Demo W10. Machine with a NetBIOS name, we will configure the local admin accounts used to access this machine, and we'll enter the domain name of where we have joined these VMs. Installation failed. This is quite logical because we have not opened any firewall ports prior to installing. There are a few ports which need to be opened. For this is the port 8000 bidirectional, so this means two-way. For this demo it's easier to just disable the firewall and we'll continue to install. Disable the firewall and we will install the agent again. As you can see, the installation has successfully completed. You can choose to select the default flow, which will be easy if you have not set up any flows before with LoadGen. If you have experience with LoadGen before this, you can just pick the blank flow. This is more than enough. For this demo purpose, we just use the default flow. Enter the SQL details of the SQL server. In our case, it's the SQL Express, which we installed on the same VM as LoadGen itself. We also create a new database. In order to use the systems under our tests, which means collecting performance metrics on the FAT client in this case, you need to have the remote registry servers started and running. So we will do that on our demo machine. Performance metrics, It can be any which are important for you. Oh, we successfully configured LoadGen, so let's fire it up. Open LoadGen Director, you're able to see a few of the options you have. The one is on the left is the current flow. This is the one that's going to be used when we start a test. LoadGen Agents test machines is our demo W10 machine. And the load scenario, in the load scenario you will describe how many users will log in and how many minutes, seconds in between the users. In this case it's only one machine, so this will not do that much. And we have the target environment. In this case it's also the Fed client, as it's and the agent and the target environment. Under run your test you can start the actual test and you can monitor the machine from here during the test to see what's happening or if there's something going wrong. LoadGen Studio, this is where we will be able to edit the flow or create new flows or add user actions to the existing flow. This means you can, for example, add Words or Microsoft Edge Chromium to your test instead of an Internet Explorer. Thanks for watching. If you would like to know more about LoadGen, please visit the website or contact me. Have a good day and see you next time.